is up YouTuber, and here today I'm going to show you guys how to install Windows Whistler Build 2276 in VirtualBox. Build 2276 is another part of Beta 1 in the Windows Whistler series, so without further ado, let's get this started. So the first thing you need is VirtualBox, the second thing you need is the ISO from Windows PC, and you're also going to need to have the MS-DOS video because we need to make sure we have MS-DOS installed. So without further ado, let's get this started. So we're going to click on new, and we're going to type in Windows Whistler build 2276, and you want to make sure you either set it to Windows 2000 or XP. You just do Windows 2000 since it's 2000 base, and obviously it's still going to say Windows 2000, and then hit next. You can increase the size to 512 by, you can leave it at 168, and then hit next. Hard drive set, we're going to set it to XP standards at 10 gigabytes, and then hit next, and then hit finish. Then click on settings, storage, click on that button right here that says add controller, and then hit the i82078 floppy controller, and then click on that disk, and you're going to look for that MS-DOS disk number 1, or just click on that and look for it, but it's in here. Then hit OK, and then hit Start. Now that's not what I meant by maximizing this thing. So let me go ahead and install MS-DOS real quick, and then until we get to the BIOS date, that's where we need to have it changed. And then right here, you just hit the up key to where it says date and time, and then hit Enter. And the date you need to change is 09/29/00. Then hit enter twice. And now go ahead and continue installing MS-DOS. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to go ahead and install MS-DOS. So I'll be back. Now that we're done, go ahead and insert the ISO. It's going to be in that directory. And that's not what I wanted. I need the hard drive. No, the optical drive. So insert that ISO, and then what we need to do is we need to type in D colon, and then hit enter, and type in dir, and then hit enter. Then type in cd space i386, and then hit enter, and then type in winnt, and then hit enter, and that's going to copy files to your hard drive. And so what I'm going to do is I'm going to pause the video, so I'll be back. Now go ahead and eject the ISO, and then hit enter. And then hit enter to start the installation. And then it's gonna start the setup. Then hit enter, F8, and then we're gonna make sure you set it to that unpartitioned space, and then hit enter. And then we're gonna set it to format the partition using the NTFS file system quick, and then hit enter. And then it's going to format the drive, then it's going to examine the drive for any bad sectors, and then it's going to copy files. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to pause the video, so I'll be back. Now it's ready to restart, so we're going to hit enter so we can restart the virtual machine. And then it should automatically set it as Windows Whistler. And then eventually we now have a new design. And this, it will be persistent up to build 2419, in which you'll see this thing right here. And then if the mouse glitches out during that time, you can go to input and then mouse integration. So just click on next, and that's going to install devices. So it's kind of now resembling kind of like Windows XP, so there you go. So what I'm going to do is I need to go ahead and pause the video, so I'll be back. When you get to the screen right here, if the mouse starts to glitch out, just now disable mouse integration. And then just click on next. Name, I'm going to type in my name here. And then hit next. Computer name, I'm going to call it Whistler 2276, or whatever computer name you want to have, and then hit next. confirm the date that is Friday, September 29th, 2000, and then hit next. And then to bring on that networking settings here. And then eventually, we should see the options for TCP/IP. Just click on next, and then leave it as is, and then hit next. Just knowing work group. And now it's going to copy files, and then eventually, it's going to complete the installation. So, what I'm going to do is I'm going to go and pause the video, so I'll be back. Now it's ready to restart, so now it's going to restart the virtual machine. And now I can hit enter to select Windows Whistler Professional. As you can see on the bottom right, it says Windows Whistler Build 2276. So it's going to apply computer settings, and then this should bring a networking setting to pop up as well, like it happened in Build 2267. But it does not happen. So there you go, you have successfully installed Windows Whistler Build 2276 in VirtualBox. If you click on start and then right click my computer and hit properties, you should see that we have successfully installed Windows Whistler Build 2276. So if you also go to run and type in WinVir, there you go. So, and then just to be aware, if you are going to shut down a machine, make sure it says it's saved the machine state. If you just turn it off and then when you start it back up, it's gonna error it out. It's going to say that the evaluation period has expired. So be aware of that. So thank you guys for watching. Please be sure to hit the subscribe button. Also follow me on Twitter at RubenAppadicio17. And also follow me on Instagram at RubenTheTransitFan. So that's how to install Windows Whistler Build 2276 in VirtualBox. So, I'll see you next time.